Ilias Ennahachi approaching the kicking range of Superlek. Look for Superlek to disrupt that forward pressure with that right roundhouse kick and also those teeps. He's great at timing the entry of movement with those front teeps.
Ennahachi. Lean, long athlete. Outside leg kick to the sciatic there from Superlek Kiatmoo9.
Superlek having a little trouble with his footing in, on this canvas.
I think he was claiming a slippery part of the canvas, but Olivia Cost had a look and said there's nothing wrong with it. Southpaw stance, good skip up round kick, taekwondo style there from Ennahachi. These are the sort of techniques that Superlek isn't used to. You don't see those in Muay Thai. Fake off the back leg there from Superlek.
I don't know if that was a fake or a slip actually again.
Yeah, it looked like he went to throw and it probably couldn't have been a feint, but he definitely slipped there.
Look how high he up on the balls of the feet Ennahachi is. Constantly moving, constantly springing. Like a jack in the box. Ennahachi. Posing danger with that lead leg. Very bladed stance on Ennahachi. Look how side on he is. Oh, Superlek turning back kick just coming into play for Superlek. You figure the guy's seen it all. But you know what? He hasn't in kickboxing. He's got 126 wins. All but one of those has been in Muay Thai. High kick there from Superlek. Yet to find any sort of rhythm, any sort of beat off that right leg. The most feared weapon. And again, there was that little slip as he was about to draw the rear leg up reach.
Yeah, this is going to be problematic because if he's having trouble firing, this is going to give Ennahachi the ability to just kind of attack at will.
Good look at the stance again there. More squared up is Superlek. More side on, that bladed stance on Ennahachi. Ennahachi looking very confident. Still just dipping their toes in the water here, seeing what each other has to offer. Ennahachi will want to test the power of Superlek. See what that right leg is like and how he can handle it. Front kick there from Ennahachi, bounds in, bounds out.
When you look at Superlek's rear leg right now, especially before he kicks, before he launches that thing, he does have a fairly flat stance, and he doesn't look to have high arches either. So maybe it is these ankle wraps that are catching the canvas for him, or slipping on the canvas, I should say.
I love how you call it that thing. It is inhuman, that weapon he possesses in that right leg, them grip. Outside leg kick attempt there from Superlek. Second round of five. First round, I went unofficially 10-9 to Ennahachi, Rich. Agreed, Mitch. Agreed all round. 10-9 Ennahachi unofficially in our scorecards. Little tango there.
Tens across the board. Here we go with Ennahachi trying to create that movement. He's so evasive, always on the balls of his feet, moving in and out.
And again, it's the problems Ennahachi presents, stuff that Superlek hasn't seen before. Can Superlek start to possibly get a read on Ennahachi? Pet Dam couldn't, and Ennahachi destroyed Pet Dam.
But in a lot of Superlek's matches, right about that halfway point of the second round, you really start to see him level up. He starts to figure out timing, understand the distance, and then he starts to let go of that right kick.
Left hook there from Ennahachi. There's the right hand from the champion. Flurrying forward now, the looping punches. Look at the extension of Ennahachi, and Superlek ties him up.
And you can just see Ennahachi there. He actually walked, which is typically a no-no, switching your leads and coming forward. But as he's doing it, he's throwing strikes while he's technically not planted with good power.
That's the problem that Pet Dam had with Ennahachi's movement. It's just that constant forward pressure. It's almost like Demetrius Johnson, how he punches, he comes forward, he changes stances, and he just keeps attacking from different angles.
In Muay Thai, there's much more planting your feet and standing in front of your opponent. And that's what Superlek's used to, and that's how he gets those kicks off. But how do you start the kicking machine? How do you wind it up against a guy like Ennahachi, who is always moving offline?
I don't know if you noticed there off of the break, but when Olivier tried pushing him back, Superlek basically said, I am not stepping out of this logo.
Must have heard you, Rich. Good outside leg kick there from Superlek. 1 minute remaining, second of five.
That's what Superlek needs to do. He has to go after those legs. Just start hammering on them. Slow down this perpetual motion coming from Ilias Ennahachi.
Ennahachi blocked that leg. Drifts off to his left. into the power side of Superlek, now away from it. Lateral movement here from the champion. Superlek winds up a single strike, needs to start some combination work. Needs to find a way to stop the movement here of Ennahachi. Ennahachi continually making Superlek guess. Lots of instructions from the champion's corner. Knees on the inside. You must be offensive in the clinch under kickboxing rules. It can never be a defensive clinch. Counter hook from Ennahachi. Some better striking. The second round going the way of Superlek, just 10-9.
I thought it was a pretty even round. I'm split that one 10-10. I didn't see a significant advantage for either one of those guys.
Mitch? I do like the leg kicks landed by Superlek in that second round, but it was pretty close. But Ilias is just still scoring with the hand combinations.
How are you scoring it, folks? Wherever you're watching in over 150 countries worldwide on our global broadcast, let us know on social media at One Championship, on Twitter, Facebook, YouTube, and Instagram. Good counter, left hand there from Ennahachi, drifts off clockwise.
Ilias checked the kick with his forearm and then came back with a punch. That was beautiful.
Superlek trying to close down the movement. There's been no chance to wind up multiple kicks for the challenger so far. Cracks that one to the forearm. Now you may say, well, those kicks are getting blocked, but they are designed to go to the forearm, break down the forearm, to try and drop the forearm of Ennahachi so Superlek can then loop over to the head, come through clean.
And you can see how Superlek's kicks are starting to welt up the arm of Ilias Ennahachi, so that arm might slowly start to come down. He's landed a lot of shots in that forearm.
I like Superlek's strategy in this round. He's walking Ennahachi down, walking Ennahachi to the cage, and then basically launching his strikes with the rear leg right there again.
See, this is the timing I was talking about, right around that middle portion of the second round. That's when Superlek really starts to find his groove. He seems to have solved the slippage problem and is now pushing forward and trying to corner Ilias Ennahachi with that right kick.
And I think we're seeing less volume from Ennahachi right now. This has been a good round for Superlek.
Well, his primary weapon has been his arms, and you can just see the damage that's accumulating on that left arm.
Matrix-style lean back there from Ennahachi. 45 seconds remains, third of five. Our world title main event here at One Championship, Fists of Fury. Keeping it nice and clean, Olivier Coste. On the front foot. Trying to close down Ennahachi's movement, land the round, kicks off the back leg. Now he winds up a couple in a row.
See, this is the tactical change that Superlek's doing. He's normally a great counter striker. He waits to make you miss, and then he makes you pay for it. But this time, he's starting to go first. He's initiating the conversation by throwing these right kicks at Ilias Ennahachi. Ilias Ennahachi needs to have an answer for that right kick.
Little parry there from Ennahachi, good defense, fight.
He's starting to really come into his own and find an answer for the movement. He's cornering Ilias Ennahachi well, but this is where Ennahachi starts to excel. Both these guys turn it up in the championship rounds.
Penultimate round here. Ennahachi gets offline nicely to avoid that round kick. Good look at the side-on stance there of Ennahachi.
Look at the way the Superlek is just walking forward and mowing him down and then launch that rear kick again.
Just for me, in the third round, guys, there was not enough output from the champion.
Superlek is a master at distance control. He shuts down clinchers, and he doesn't give them space to work. And then when people want space and they have that evasive movement, he creates this distance and range that where he is at an advantage.
Ennahachi is moving a lot, but he's not offering enough offensively.
He wasn't the first two, but yeah. Superlek solved the puzzle. He solved the riddle of Ilias Inahachi's movement. Ilias needs to switch things up a little bit.
Ennahachi wades out with the right hand. Superlek ties him up. 1:45 remaining. Solid round again for Superlek so far. Not too late, though, for Ennahachi to turn it back in his favor. But he has not got the output that he had in the opening round in particular, not working those angles, not flurrying forward, not looping the punches as much.
That was a better combination. He threw the three-touch combination, and then he got out.
Uppercut. Off the hooking punches from Ennahachi. Superlek walking him down. Cracks away to the forearm.
You see that body on the left side of Ennahachi starting to redden up as well, not just the arm.
Superlek calling Ennahachi forward. Wants to engage a little more here. Superlek Kiatmoo9. The kicking machine hasn't gotten into those double digits tonight. There's a double round kick.
If you notice, Superlek doesn't throw a kick when you're stationary. He kicks you when you're trying to move. When you're trying to initiate a shot, he throws you off balance. He catches you mid-footwork, so it disrupts your balance even more.
Head kick there from Superlek. Catch an attempted sweep from the champion. Shakes his head, says, nope, didn't hurt me. Good one, tucks it under the left arm. That body getting banged up on Ilias Ennahachi.
See how he moves Ennahachi with these kicks? It's because Ilias is trying to throw something, so his weight is not perfectly distributed.
I'll tell you this much, whatever issues Superlek had at the beginning of this match with his footing.
And he's unofficial, of course. We have three judges circle side, and nicely done early there from Ennahachi. Not completely legal, though, under these kickboxing rules, but sending a message to Superlek that he is still here and will not be manhandled.
He might be there, but did you see the way Superlek evaded that high kick, landed the body kick? Ilias couldn't do anything else but catch the kick and try to throw him down, which you're not allowed to do under kickboxing rules.
Superlek again, careening that right leg into the forearm, the bicep, the tricep, trying to tuck it under the left elbow of Ennahachi. Oh, you hear the impact. Both corners very vocal here. Ennahachi tries for a counter hook reach.
Yeah, I think Ennahachi has been used to countering and striking his opponents when he's off balance, like moving out at weird angles. But every time Superlek lands one of these kicks, it takes Ennahachi so much off balance that he has an inability to actually counter off that.
Trying to scoop away that one, Ennahachi. Drifting off counterclockwise now, away from the right leg. Ennahachi comes forward, gets out of dodge. Looks like he was almost moonwalking, man. Trying to pose angles, but while he's moving so much, he's not landing anything that scores for him, Ennahachi. Superlek continues to come forward. Ennahachi tries to stick him with that left hook. 110 remains, fifth and final round.
You can see he's trying to circle away. He's circling to Rodlek's left side, which is avoiding the power, but what we're not seeing from Ennahachi is that flurry of punches he was doing in the first and second. He was a lot more active in those first few rounds, and he's just taking his foot off the gas, shift down gears, and allowing Superlek to score with those right kicks.
It's a good stiff right hand to the top of the head there from Superlek as well as Ennahachi waded in. Under 40 seconds remains. We've got Ennahachi trailing.
This is a beautiful technical fight that's going on.
Ennahachi loops the left, jogs away, looks to his corner, resets. They tie up now. Gotta stay offensive in the clinch. Olivier Cost doesn't see it, breaks them. Superlek moves him with the knee. Just got it to the left rib cage. Final seconds here. We are going to go down to the judges in Singapore in our main event. Who will win the One Super Series?